Hi, I'm Sarah, and I work for Girl Scouts of the USA, and I'm a member of the program team. I also am a troop leader here in Brooklyn, New York, and I'm a member of the Girl Scouts of Greater New York Council. And I'm here today to talk to you a little bit about emergency first aid, specifically how to make emergency splints. This activity should take somewhere between 1 and 2 hours, and you need just a very simple set of supplies. You'll need something that will allow you to get on the internet, so a phone that has internet access, a computer, a tablet, whatever you've got that's handy. You're also going to need some easy to find supplies in order to make your own splint. Now, I'm going to have you do some research in a little bit about what the characteristics of those supplies should be, and you're going to test them out to find out what works best, so I am not going to give you a list of what those supplies are right now. First, I want you to think about what are the most important characteristics of a splint. Stop and think about it. The point, and remembering what the point of it is. So the point of it is to keep whatever the injury is from moving around. So maybe you need something firm, maybe you need something to tie whatever the thing is to the body. I want you to do some research. So pause this video, go online, figure out what you might need and what you might want to try out as part of your emergency splint. I want you to find 4 or 5 different sets of things. Keep in mind that we're testing things. The first time you use a splint, we really don't want that to actually be in an emergency. So we're gonna test it out and see what works and what doesn't work and see what we can improve. So pause the video, go find what you need, and then come back. Okay, welcome back. So I went and collected some things too. So I have a wooden spoon that I think might be useful. I also grabbed this stick, which I think is sturdy enough. It's not very thick, but it's pretty sturdy. So we're gonna test it and see. I'm not sure what the thickness needs to be. I also have a rolled up towel, which is unexpectedly firm. And I think might be comfortable were you to have an injury. So we're gonna test that too. And then as far as attaching, I grabbed a few things that I generally always have with me in my pack. So first, socks. If anybody's had blisters, hiking, extra pair of socks, very important. I think in this case, it might be very useful. I also have some rope, and I grabbed my belt. Before you start applying your splint, there are a few things that you need to be aware of, and you may have found this in your research already. The first is, if the injury is bleeding, you need to stop the bleeding first. So you need to apply pressure to the wound, stop the bleeding, make sure that it's covered. The American Red Cross has some great tips and advice about how to treat bleeding injuries that you should certainly look at. The next thing you need to do is that you need to apply some padding. So this could be anything. It could be a t-shirt, it could be the sock that I had. I bet you can pull the sock up over an injury and cover that up nicely because your splint's going to be a little hard. Once you've done that, then you can place the splint. So you want to make sure, let's imagine that the injury that I've strained or broken my forearm here. So the splint can't go just here under my forearm. It actually needs to extend beyond both joints that are nearest the injury. So in this case, my wrist and my elbow. So I'm gonna grab my spoon. All right, so if I was placing this spoon would indeed be long enough because I can get it below my wrist and above my elbow. So you would place it like that so that my forearm can't be moved, right? If you had it just above the wrist or below the wrist, so the wrist is not immobilized, it's much easier for, see my forearm is still moving there. So that's gonna cause pain, that's not immobilizing the injury. So you really need to make sure that it's past both joints on either side of your injury. The next thing you need to do is attach it. So whether or not that is using a belt or your a pair of socks or a rope or whatever you have, it could be even a sweatshirt if you're out hiking. So anything that will and make sure that this is firmly attached. Once you firmly attach your firm piece of your splint, you need to check them to make sure you haven't cut off circulation because you can't tie it too tight. If you tie it too tight, the signs of that you've attached your splint too tightly, fingers could be turning blue, things could start swelling, it could get pale. So you need to make sure you don't do that. So you need to check every few minutes to make sure that your splint isn't too tight. Keep in mind, as injuries, the injury is likely going to swell. which means that a perfectly tied splint that is not cutting off circulation when you first start it is very likely later on to need to be loosened up a little bit. So if the person complains about injuries, about things hurting near the ties, you should try to loosen them up. The other thing that I should mention is to make sure your ties don't ever go directly above the wound. You want the ties on either side of the wound so that you're not applying undue pressure to the wound itself. So once you've done that and your person is, or the injury is firmly secured, now you need to call the professionals. So call 911, emergency services, go to the nearest emergency room. You've done your part, now you need to do the second piece of your job, which is to get them to professional care. So, and now I want you to test out everything you put together, figure out what works best so that the first time you use a splint, it doesn't need to be in the middle of an emergency. And then once you've completed that, you will have completed one step to earning the Girls Are Superhero patch. And you can go to girlscouts.org/superheroes to find out what the other two steps are you need to complete in order to earn the patch. I hope you've had a good time today. If you enjoyed this activity, please share it with your friends. And if you are not a Girl Scout, please consider joining. Go to girlscouts.org and find some more information about Girl Scouts. You can also reach out to your local council and ask them lots of questions. So I hope you enjoyed this. Be safe. Have fun.